It's old time hockey, the way you're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way. You play like Gordie Howe or Eddie fucking Shore. We can't all be Gretzky, some user Bobby Orr's. Hey!
The Ottawa Senators trade Alexi Ashen to the New York Islanders in exchange for Zdeno Chara, Bill McCulloch, and the second overall pick in this year's draft, the next pick.
Ottawa Senators select from Windsor Spitfires, Jason Spezza.
The Ottawa Senators first round.
Well, I think fans in Ottawa have to be very happy with that pick. You know, he's an Ontario boy. This kid can score goals, and the Ottawa Senators need that. I think he's a real nice fit for that team.
If there ever was a reason to get excited about the Ottawa Senators in the early to mid-2000s, it was Jason Spezza. Spezza would start his junior career playing for the Brampton Battalion of the Ontario Hockey League. In his first season, during the 98-99 campaign, Spezza played 67 games, scoring 22 goals with 49 assists for 71 points. And being only 15 years old at the time, Spezza was projected to be the next prodigy. Many comparisons to Steve Yzerman and Mario Lemieux were made. During the 99-2000 season, Spezza entered the OHL priority draft and was selected by the Mississauga Ice Dogs. Continuing his point-per-game dominance of the league, Spezza, playing in 52 games, scored 24 times and got 37 assists for 61 points. It was only 15 games into the following season that Spezza requested a trade and was reassigned to the Windsor Spitfires. During his 15 games at the beginning of the year with the Ice Dogs, he scored 7 times and got 23 assists for 30 points, an astonishing 2 points per game before being traded. After joining Windsor, Spezza went on a tear. In 41 games, he scored 36 times and notched 50 assists for 86 points, continuing his 2 points per game average for the rest of the year. It was this 116 points in 56 games that caught the attention of NHL scouts, who had been watching Spezza with a lot of attention since he entered the OHL. But his stock definitely rose after this season. He was projected to be number 1 or number 2 in the 2001 NHL entry draft. The Atlanta Thrashers ultimately went with Ilya Kovalchuk, which meant that Spezza was going to be number 2 and join the New York Islanders. If it wasn't for the last-minute trade that saw Alexi Yashin go to the Islanders for forward Bill McCulloch and defenseman Zdeno Chara and the Islanders' second-round pick, Spezza would have ended up in Long Island. But Spezza was drafted to the Ottawa Senators second overall in the 2001 entry draft. He was very thrilled to be selected by a Canadian team. Spezza would not make his NHL debut that next season, but stayed in the OHL and split time between the Windsor Spitfires and Belleville Bulls, playing in 53 games and getting an amazing 105 points. Spezza definitely eased into the NHL, not becoming a full-time starter right away, but instead being brought up slowly and carefully. In the 2002-2003 season, he split time between Ottawa and the Binghamton Senators of the NHL, playing only 33 games for Ottawa, but scoring 7 goals and getting 14 assists. He would play 43 games in Binghamton, where he would score 22 goals and get 54 points. Spezza would play his first full NHL season in 2003-2004, playing in 78 games, scoring 22 goals and getting 33 assists for 55 points. During the 04-05 lockout, Spezza spent time back in the AHL playing for Binghamton, playing in 80 games, scoring 32 times and getting 85 assists for 117 points, definitely helping his development. After the 04-05 lockout, NHL resumed play in 05-06, and Spezza would stay in the NHL from that point onward, playing the next 9 seasons for the Ottawa Senators, posting his best 3 career seasons to start off his career. In 05-06, he would score 90 points, the next year 87, and in 07-08, 92 for a career high. It was during the 06-07 run that Ottawa would make it to the Stanley Cup final, thanks to an amazing front line that was led by Spezza with Daniel Alfredsson and Danny Heatley. At the end of the 2014 season, Jason Spezza had requested a trade from the Ottawa Senators. He was traded to the Dallas Stars on July 1st, 2014. He would spend the next 5 years playing in Dallas, putting up 50 points or more in his first three seasons, but in his last two seasons with the Stars, his production would dip below 30 points in two full seasons. At the beginning of the 1920 season, Spezza signed with his longtime favorite Toronto Maple Leafs. He would play in 58 games of the shortened season and score 9 times and get 25 points. The following season, Spezza was placed on waivers by the Leafs due to salary cap issues. Spezza was then re-signed by the Maple Leafs after clearing waivers and is where he's playing today. And as of this recording, he has played in 22 games of the 2021 NHL season, has scored 5 goals, and has 7 assists for 12 points. All in total, Jason Spezza has played in 1,145 NHL games, scored 346 goals, and gotten 606 assists for 952 points. Spezza has also been a mainstay on Team Canada for international play, winning 2 bronze medals and a silver medal at the World Junior Championships in 2000, 2001, and 2002. Winning 2 silver medals at the World Hockey Championships in 08 and 09, and winning a gold medal at the World Hockey Championship in 2015, as well as a Spangler Cup win in 2013. All in all, Spezza has had a great career and will continue to do so. I feel that definitely he will be a Hall of Famer in due time. With his on and off ice leadership and selflessness when it comes to playing the game. Just listen to what Don Cherry thinks about Jason Spezza during his time with the Mississauga Ice Dogs.
Remember the time, I think we told this once before, that when he was with the Ice Dogs, he wouldn't shoot the puck.
He's the only guy in the world that scored. He was mad. So I said to Tim, I said, should I go down and tell him to shoot the puck?
Because it was first two periods. He'd be walking in cold turkey.
And he'd pass around.
He'd pass.
And that was, he had a bad habit. And so anyhow, I went down, I said, shoot the puck. And I really reamed him. So the first minute out, he gets the puck. And did he blast it? He knocked it. And he was mad. The guys pushed the guys away.
Yeah, he scored. I'm trying to think of that. The goal he made the National Hockey League, he was against Kingston. And it hit his glove and put his glove right in the net.
I mean, he really can shoot.
And he skated right to the bench and sat down.
Yeah, and he was mad. It's old time hockey, the way we're supposed to play. You throw a little lumber if a guy gets in your way.